Hey everybody, this is MG Vids with some more Great Little War Game 2. Today we're taking on Mission 12, which is Eliminate the Enemy General. This level is interesting because it's got a narrow choke point over here in between both sides. Alright, got it. Essentially, you can only get one troop at a time through this little gap. Now, this level also introduces the fairies, so I can begin shuttling troops across. And that's going to be my intent. So what I'm going to try to do, I'm not going to worry about this barracks. I feel like that's kind of goading you into taking that. So instead, undo that. I do not want to buy an engineer. I've got an engineer. I want to send this engineer over to take over that oil rig. I'm also going to bring my landing craft around. So I'm going to take that oil rig, and I'm going to try to basically plug this hole with one to two grunts and a sniper just to hold off the enemy forces. They will probably send engineers down here to take over this barracks, but I'm not really worried about that because they're operating on three rigs, and I'll be operating on three rigs. Now, what I am going to do is I added the grenadier, which you're going to want to do because he's basically got area weapons. So let's start loading up our landing craft. I'm going to put one grenadier on this landing craft, and then I'm also going to wait till this third vessel gets around, load that up as well, because the grenadier, since he does area damage, will be great for this little area. There's two snipers and four grunts, and we're just going to push through here and go straight for the general, because even as they flood troops around, you see they have a narrow choke point. They have two they need to get through. Their base only allows one unit through at a time. So that's basically everybody. We will keep that guy there for now. We'll move him forward. That's fine. And we'll turn it back over to the computer. So they've got two choke points to go through. You know, they'll flood guys out, but then to bring them back, they need to go through the same one area. Now, I've played this level a few times, and initially I was playing it without even unlocking the grenadier, and I'm going to tell you right now, you don't want to do that. You need the grenadier to be successful. So don't think sniper. Make sure you unlock him before you get to this level. Otherwise, it's just going to be really, you're just not going to be able to do much, because anything you land back here is just going to get destroyed really quickly. And it's just frustrating. The star is on this little low ground here, so, you know, play through once, go ahead and grab it, and then come back. Maybe use those battle points to unlock the grenadier. Now, my grunts, I want to say they're leveled all the way up, which is nice, except, yeah, see, here they go. So I'm going to be plugging these holes with grunts entire time. Okay, now move this landing craft over one more. Let's pump out one grunt here to take across. We're going to take all three. And what you have to watch out for is the computer might build out either a grenadier or a bazooka guy to attack your landing craft. Now, so just be aware of that, because they can fire over this barrier. The grenadier I'm actually going to drop back here, and the reason being is because now he can hit everything. If you keep him on the one of the front three spots, he'll actually miss a few of the front troops. Here he can hit everybody. Now we can go ahead and bring up our guys. Not going to worry about taking out the snipers just yet. We're going to go ahead and eliminate the guys with the most life. So the snipers might kill my grunts, but then the grenadiers will get them. We can't move back our landing craft really yet. I can take them back one space, and I'm going to do that just in case they get a bazooka guy out. I don't want them to start doing damage to me. Now, additionally, we'll buy another grunt right now. With the sniper here, we're going to go ahead and eliminate that first person. We'll also push forward and attack Bazooka Man. Get the sniper out of the way. Move the grunt back. Again, by pushing the sniper over that just one little spot, It actually allows me to stay out of the direct line of fire, so they'd have to come around the corner. Now the computer will probably go straight for the base here pretty soon. Again, I'm fine with them taking that because it's not, you know, even if they built troops out there, once I begin attacking, see how they're starting to move back, it's going to be pulling folks away. So that's fine. Regardless of where they're at, man, he can still range that even if I moved it back a spot. So Grenadier has got some range. Let's eliminate some of this. Alright. Boy, you know what would actually be kind of neat is to put him back on the landing craft. Send him all the way back so he can't get attacked. And basically, I'm just going to keep him alive while I pump out two more grunts, load them back on the landing craft, and then I'll send everybody back across because I'd like to keep him alive as long as I can. He'd actually work good. You don't need him to knock out the general, but because there's two other little guys around him, it's not bad, right? Okay. We've got this guy here. Right and ready. Standing by. In my sights. He's almost dead. What's next? Roger, we'll go. Orders. Why don't we move him back a space? What's next? In my sights. Dr. Zan.
Good to go.
Standing by.
Orders.
Ma'am. I mean, yes, ma'am.
Okay. Not really kind of how I wanted to be set up here, but that's all right. We're ready to make a push now this next turn. We'll knock out those snipers, get the grunts on the ground, and begin running forward. See, they're already going around to reinforce. That's fine, though, because I've got that Grenadier there. I'd like to be pushed out a little bit farther on the front there, but you know, he reinforced pretty fast with a Grenadier. That happens. Okay. I cannot believe that guy did not die.
Dr. Zan, licking chicken. Ma'am. Ma'am. On point.
Shoot him, because the sniper can go ahead and take out this little bazooka guy.
I'm on it.
And hopefully we get him promoted.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now let's send all these landing craft across.
Yes. Peace. Okay. What's next? In my sights.
Now I can push him up because here we go. We're gonna kill all the snipers. Oh, didn't that one on the left have a skeleton on?
What's next? Give me something.
Okay, now we're gonna kill that sniper.
Safety's off. Give me something.
And let's go ahead and push him up.
Yes.
Just one notch here. Take another pop shot and eliminate him. There is the Grenadier there, but I should survive the initial attack because they're leveled up all the way, right? Let's start bringing our landing craft back, even though apparently he can still range me. And let's go ahead and buy. Let's go ahead and take two more grunts. Because we just want to be able to keep pounding the beach. If we need to go ahead and reinforce this right side, we can, but that should be good enough to kind of hold them there. They're going to be sending everybody now around the side trying to stop me from advancing. Or they should be, because now they're cranking all kinds of units. Alright, we lived. What I'd like to do is be able to get that Grenadier up there. Sending another Grenadier. Yeah, it's like they just pumped out like $450 worth of stuff. Whatever. I get frustrated sometimes when the computer all of a sudden is coming out with insane amount of resources, even though, you know, he and I are basically the same, but that's why you get more rewards when you beat him. Right, for these levels now, they're worth 100 versus 50 when we first started. pump out just one grunt here. We'll save the other 75 in case we want to buy something else. I don't think there's really a need to get the additional the additional landing craft.
Orders. I got you, pansy. You need me, Roger Wilco.
Do I want to do that? The Grenadier's gonna get me if I do that. I don't think I want to do that, but I would kill him.
Yes, sir.
It's fine. He can do area damage on the grunts. What I want to avoid.
Sir, good to go. Standing by.
Orders.
Start working the Grenadier that way. Take out this guy now. Perfect. And then what I'm gonna do is this should work. I'm gonna move Grunt up. I'm gonna slide the sniper in. Only to shoot. Right, there's that little choke point, so he takes the shot. Then I'm gonna slide the sniper back out of the way. Move him up there. And I'm gonna end like that. So I'll move the sniper out to shoot, drop the sniper back. I'm just trying to keep him alive as long as I can. Taking a shot in the head. Yeah, see, there's 150, so that should be able. That should be all he can bring out, because again, he's only cranking out 150 per turn, just like me. And now we've got that grunt in the back that we're going to be able to bring all the way up and reinforce. Ooh, right in the back. All right. Now let's make a run on the general here, and then if we need to, we'll worry about making more troops in a second. Alright, first let's get this.
Consider it done.
Let's just toss a grenade up there.
On it, I'm on it.
Hit everybody, that worked out really great. And then smoke him. So there you go. Not too bad. Like I said, a few troops there on the right to close that choke point down, and then really focus all the grunts and one grenadier up that across the beach. It works out good. So mission 12's done. We took the general down. We'll see you in the next gameplay videos, MG Vids. And encourage you to subscribe to the channel if you like the content we bring to YouTube to keep seeing everything. We'll see you in our next video. Thanks.